coming up on this Grand Circle Tour podcast, Detour.
I can't even hide my TV wires, and he has everything wired in this house, and you cannot see one wire.
That's a tough part about doing something like this. That's, you know, when you're on the ride, for example, even though it's an omni mover and it spins and everything, it's a linear experience. So They determine where they want you to look.
It's Airbnb Haunted Mansion style right now on the Grand Circle Tour podcast, brought to you by Victor Naraki Realtor, serving Disney and the greater Orlando area with CelebratingFlorida.com and DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com. Realtor Victor Naraki makes living near Walt Disney World a reality, specializing in all the communities surrounding Disney. Whether you're looking to relocate or invest in a new property, maybe you want a vacation home for your retirement. With over a decade of experience in the area, Victor will adapt to your needs, help you find the right property, or get you the best price for your property. Reach out to him today on his website, CelebratingFlorida.com, or at DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com. Follow him at Victor Naraki Realtor on Facebook, and don't forget to tell him the Grand Circle Tour podcast sent you.
Was the nightmare before Christmas, and all through the house. Not a creature was blissful, not even a mouse. The stockings all hung by the chimney with care, when opened that morning would cause such a scare. The children, nestled all snug in their beds, would have nightmares of monsters and skeleton heads.
Hello, boys and ghouls, and welcome to another edition of the Grand Circle Tour podcast, ever having a detour show. And joining us today is my favorite co-host, Ringmaster Holly. How are you today, Holly?
I'm good. I'm really excited for this episode. Oh my goodness, so excited.
Oh, we've been talking about this for weeks that we wanted to have. Yeah. So we want to welcome our special guest. Oh my gosh, I don't even know his last name. Jeff, what's your last name?
Last name is Schiefelbein. It's a tough one.
It's a good thing I didn't have to read it.
Yeah, right. Good thing you didn't try that one.
Yeah, for sure.
Now I know why he didn't type it out on the screen. It would have taken up the whole screen.
Well, there's no way they're going to be able to say this.
So Jeff, Jeff is the owner. I'm not sure if you're the sole owner. We're going to get into it, but he has a Airbnb in Southern California, about 50-minute drive from Disneyland, and it's a haunted mansion themed Airbnb. Now, when you think in a themed Airbnb, sometimes there's a couple of pictures on the wall or a hanging or something like that. No, this isn't that. This is an all out. You're in Disneyland's haunted mansion when you're staying at this Airbnb. I want to get into finding out how many people got scared staying there, stuff like that. If you get phone calls in the middle of the night. Holly, what do you, I know we got a lot of stuff to talk on. We don't have very much time. Jeff, we really appreciate your time coming up for this. Holly, do you want to start off welcoming Jeff to the show and whatnot?
Yeah. So first of all, I don't even know how we got Jeff on the show right now. I'm so excited because this is his season, and I was worried, like, how are we going to get him on? But so recently I was fortunate enough to stay at his Airbnb, and like Stan is saying, it's amazing. Honestly, when I walked in, I almost cried because it was so authentic. And what was really funny is I was the first one in. That there was six of us total. And a couple minutes or an hour or so, another one of my friends showed up. And I heard her say, I think I'm going to cry, because we're such big Disney fans. And like Stan is saying, it's not just a themed Airbnb. Like he's saying, you can see Airbnbs where they're themed, they'll have something painted. This, I felt like I walked into the ride. It was so amazing. And I think I texted you right away and said, like, wow, like, I am absolutely blown away. I know you have cameras in there. And if you watched my face when I walked in there, like, I was in complete awe. So I know that you only have a few photos posted, and I think I totally probably exploited your house, because I have nonstop talked about this, your house. I've done a live. We've done so many reels on Instagram. We just thoroughly enjoyed this house, and I cannot recommend it enough. So this is really, really exciting for me.
What we should point out, though, is now, Holly, when you went, so just like the Haunted Mansion at Disneyland, it gets that Nightmare Before Christmas overlay.
Yes.
For the months of October through partway through January. Jeff, you do the same thing at your Airbnb. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Yeah. So this was something we decided to do that. You know, we figured, well, we're doing the Haunted Mansion. Let's just kind of follow Disney's footsteps and let's go ahead and do a little, overlay of Nightmare Before Christmas.
Little.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'll be honest with you. I mean, if you saw the list of things we wanted to do. So, you know, everybody just kept saying, there's always next year. You got to add a little bit at a time, a little bit at a time. You know, don't do everything. So, so we did this overlay, and it was a lot of fun. We tried to keep in mind that we only, you know, obviously we had to close the place down for about a week. I think it was about 5 days. And wow. So we wanted to try to, you know, accomplish as much as we could. And I think we did well. I think it turned out better than I expected. There's so much more like I want to add, and we're going to, but it's going to be one of those things. Every year we want to, you know, we want people to come back. We want people to come back and see all the new things we've added. And that goes even the same for just the normal Haunted Mansion theme. Like, by the early next year, we already have anticipated, we're already planning on bringing in some new things, some new set pieces, some prop pieces, and more effects and stuff like that. So we're going to continually keep, you know, adding to the experience.
So this is the first year you've done the overlay? Is
yes.
that correct?
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, wow. Yes. Oh, wow.
Yeah. Wow.
Even like year three or something for sure.
Yes. No, even no. more impressed. So I actually want to go off of that. So one of the things that I noticed was the detail. And sorry, Stan, if I'm just like jumping in, but I'm just so excited. So the detail of this house is so incredible. Did you start your, so you're saying this was the first year you've done the overlay. Did you start the house and it was like, boom, done? Or have you added the details over the years? Because there's just so much.
Most everything you see in there now, I'm trying to think if there was anything really added. There were some small things that were added over the past, since we opened. I think the property has been open now for almost 2 years, about a year,
oh my gosh.
Year wow. and a half, year, almost
okay.
2 years.
Okay.
But pretty much everything that you see was initial. It was all done all at once. We spent about two months doing all the decorating and installing everything. And yeah, it was a lot of work. I mean, a lot of people don't realize. I mean, what's crazy is it's one thing if you're building something from ground up, but now we're taking an existing house that, you know, has its normal everything, normal electrical, normal walls and everything. And, you know, what a lot of people don't realize is throughout the house, for example, like we have candelabras I guess that would be the word for it, right? The candelabras that are mounted to the wall.
Like the sconces. Yeah, the sconces.
On the wall. Sconces. Yeah.
That are throughout the house that have the flickering bulbs and everything in it. Like, you can't just get those bulbs to flicker. So we had to literally, everywhere those sconces are, all the walls had to be ripped up. All new electrical had to be run through the whole house just to install a flickering, you know, effects box. And that runs through all of the walls, you know. So it's just even things like that. It's like, okay, well, they have a flickering box. I'm like, yeah, we had to rip the whole entire house apart. Just redo this electrical.
I have to tell you, we noticed the electricity because one of my friends said, I am so impressed. There's not a single wire that you can view in this whole house. Mm-hmm. And she said, I can't even hide my TV wires. And he has everything wired in this house and you cannot see one wire. So
that
didn't go unnoticed.
That's a tough part about doing something like this. That's, you know, when you're on the ride, for example, even though it's an omni mover and it spins and everything, it's a linear experience. So they determine where they want you to look. And when they want you to look at something, you know, if you were to stop from where they want you to look and look behind you, you can see all of the lighting and all of the gear and everything because, you know, they don't want you to see that. So they can control that. So that was kind of the tough thing here, is to still give people the experience without it looking like a show where, you know, you can turn around and see all the lights or the wires or right. the, you know, so that was kind of the tough thing, to still be able to immerse you and you can look everywhere and see everything without kind of pulling you out of the realism of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not a movie set where you can have fake walls behind and stuff like that. Right. It's an actual house that you're staying in.
Right.
So
what when you made mentioned you that, choose? Oh, go ahead, Sam.
When you mentioned the we overdid the overlay. How many people on your team and how long? You said it took 5 days. Is this 12-hour days, five people?
I would say there was probably at any given time, 4 to 5 people, actually. And, you know, we spent, a couple months kind of slowly putting pieces together and getting kind of everything ready, knowing that, you know, we're only going to have a few days to get in there. So, you know, we kind of had everything on standby. And then once we went in, it was kind of go, go, go. I honestly don't feel, I didn't feel, to be honest, I was very nervous and at the beginning that we'd have enough time and everything. And it actually went really smooth. It didn't feel too overwhelming. I didn't feel like we were working 14-hour days or anything. You know, we put in full days, but it actually went really smooth. So it worked out really nicely. We were all very very calm, and it was like, wow, okay, let's not jinx this, but everything's just kind of going nicely right now.
Well, that's good. You know, next year it's going to be easier for you, and the year after be even easier. But like you said, the more you add, it's going to, you know, for sure.
Yeah.
So what's your background? How did this come about?
Well, I'm a production designer. I build and design props, special effects, and sets, and everything for TV, film, music videos, live stage shows, stuff like that all over the world. And somehow when I was a bit younger, I want to say kind of when I was really starting out, I was always into Halloween. I grew up mm-hmm. my whole life just obsessed with Halloween, building haunted houses in our front yard and taking over the whole house, where my parents are just like, this is enough. You've taken over the driveway, the garage, the front yard, the backyard. You know, it's time to stop this. Go find somewhere else to build up. Very supportive. And so I kind of always grew up doing that. And when I was doing production, somehow I just kind of started to become this, oh, he's the Halloween guy. He's the guy, you mm-hmm. know. So even all the production work I do, I primarily am like, my busiest season is Halloween. People like, I do work for Knott's, and I've built props for Universal's Horror Nights and the Knott's Scary Farm. I've done stuff with them. So I've done haunted houses all over, all through China, everywhere.
Wow.
Yeah. So I've done the mazes for the Queen Mary. Haunted hayride. So I've kind of been a part of a lot of, you know, everything that especially is Southern California.
So this kind of answers my question as to why Haunted Mansion and not Tiki Room or the Caribbean. This is your wheelhouse, basically.
And the thing is, you know, I have every intention to do more things that aren't Haunted Mansion. You know, not to jump around too much, but I am looking to do probably at least 2 more Airbnbs that are in the works. And I say in the works, we're constantly looking for properties. I actually have our realtors right now looking next to Disney World and Fullerton in Florida, because mm-hmm. Our plan is to do the Haunted Mansion in Florida as well.
Oh, wow.
But of course, with a more of that version done into the house. So that's kind of our next step. And then, you know, one big one that a lot of people want us to do is a very interactive Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yep.
So, those are things we definitely want to do. The Haunted Mansion for me was just it's just something I literally have to thank. It is the Haunted Mansion that got me into doing what I do today. When I was little, my parents would always take us to Disneyland, and just something about the Haunted Mansion inspired me to do all my haunted houses at home. And I was, you know, doing blood effects at 8 or 9 years old, walking around with full blood on me, and always making my parents think that I fell down and cracked my head open.
Razor blade in the wrist, in the arm.
I did all that stuff. And and then I started doing the haunted houses, and that was kind of my big first production work. And then, so to this day, I mean, everything production all goes back to the Haunted Mansion. And so I'm not as much as I love horror, you know, a lot of people that I meet that don't really know me and know that I'm kind of a haunted house guy, they think I probably live in like the Munster's house that, you know, it's just like, you know, oh my God, I can't imagine what your house looks like. I'm like, my house is so modern and just, you would
normal.
Never think I would do Halloween at my house. So, I mean, so I do funny. It 24/7, you know, I have my, you know, whether it's my shop and everything, I just don't want to live in it. Now my office and everything is haunted mansion and all my collectibles and stuff like that, but my house is not, it's not the Munster's house or anything like that. So I always said, like, growing up that, oh my God, I would love to live in the actual Haunted Mansion. To, like, live in here would be amazing, you know? And then eventually I was like, I don't know if I want to live there. But so that was this opportunity to where, like, when Airbnb started becoming a thing, and I was like, I mean, I could actually do this. I could make the Haunted Mansion just like I always wanted to. And I could let other people stay there and stay there for a night or a weekend or whatever. And that was kind of it. That was like, I was able to like bring my lifelong dream to life, like to build my own haunted mansion and without having to live in it full time. So,
right.
and, you know, use it as a business, you know, and as an investment just in property in general.
Is this like your first Airbnb attempt?
Yes. Yeah, it is.
Okay. Well.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's my first one. So, it was a lot of learning though. A lot of learning.
Yeah.
So,
well, I think you did really well, especially for your first one. I keep mentioning it too. I've stayed in a good amount of Airbnbs and some, I mean, nothing themed, just to stay somewhere. And on top of being amazing and fun, it's also immaculate clean. Like, it was so clean. So in addition to being fun, and then outside, there wasn't a speck of dirt, even outside. Like, it was beautiful. And I was really impressed by that as well.
That's good.
So,
That means our housekeepers and everything are doing a great job.
Yeah.
Immaculate.
Well,
that was one thing I said to Holly, though. It needs more spider webs.
Yeah.
There wasn't very many spider webs. There was
What's funny, now that you bring that up, because I do have to go in and re-web the house. But what's interesting...
And tell the cleaners to stop taking him down.
Right. Yeah, what we would do, you know, all the fake webbing up in the light fixtures and stuff like that. And kind of near the first 6 months of having the house, you know, we kind of went through a bunch of different housekeepers till we found, you know, the ones that really loved being there. You know, they wanted to be there for what it was. And every time we went in, those cobwebs were down. They're like, they keep cleaning the cobwebs. I'm like, leave the cobwebs. This is supposed to be there.
I believe hearing a story that the same thing happened at Disneyland when it first opened too, with the Haunted Mansion, that the cleaners were actually cleaning the cobwebs all the time, and they were like, can you please stop doing that?
Exactly, yeah. So, yeah, it's due for some re-webbing.
So funny. So, did you have assistance from an Imagineer, or you just love this ride so much that you know every detail of it? Because it's perfection. It really is.
Thank you. I mean, you know, I have not really talked to anybody, any Imagineers or anything like that. I think everything from just the internet and watching tons of videos of what people have done, photographs and stuff. And I mean, I can't even tell you how many times that I've gone through, and especially leading up to this, where there's like, no matter how many videos I've watched or anything, it's like, okay, there are a couple certain details that I can't find anywhere online. Like, I need clear video or a clear photograph of, like, you know, these certain things, because I need to know really what I have to do to replicate them.
Right.
So, I rode that thing 100 times in the past year, just trying to, you know, go through and take a couple photos and, oh, they're blurry. Well, got to go back in again.
Just hoping would break down at the spot that you wanted to break down.
Yeah, I'm sure you're like trying to just get up and make the ride stop. Or,
yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Just lay your scarf out a little bit or something.
Yeah. So, just a lot of time just really researching and looking. And, you know, a lot of the elements, like just the detail on the doors and stuff, just trying to nail that down. And I brought in two 3D rendering 3D artists and stuff. So I was able to take, and I own, like, in my little shop and stuff, I own like a lot of 3D printers and stuff like that. So I was able to take a lot of these images and photos and stuff and give them to the 3D artists, and they would recreate them for me, and then I would print them all out on my 3D printer. So all the detail and the door handles and all the stuff were all done by 3D artists, and then I was able to reproduce them.
Yeah, one of my favorite details of the house is the doors of all the, and the ceilings, like those were incredible. And then it's funny, so there's a room in the house that's the stretching room, and I swear that room was gonna stretch, like it is so spot on that I was like, okay, it's gonna stretch, because I felt like I was really in the stretching room. So
you have no idea how bad I wanted that thing to stretch.
I can imagine.
I'm like, can we please just raise the roof of the house 20 feet and let me do this? And we literally, we actually really considered it at the beginning, at the beginning stages, and just the cost and permitting and how, it was just, maybe we can do projection stuff and whatever. And we're like,
maybe you could do it in Florida.
Maybe, yeah.
Where they don't have as many regulations as California, but.
Or even if there was a way for the wainscoting to go down or something.
Sure, absolutely. Yeah. So maybe. So we've talked about different ways.
If he can do it, he'll figure it out.
Yeah. But yeah. When Holly was showing us that room, and she said that I felt like this, like she was waiting for it to stretch. I said, I could guarantee you Jeff wanted that to stretch.
Oh, 100%. 100%.
When we did the live show, the number one question everybody was asking is, where did you get this stuff? Where did you get this stuff? Now, you mentioned like you do the 3D printing and all that. The one I'm really curious about are for the Nightmare Before Christmas skulls are throughout the house. Oh, yeah. You got one on the front door.
Yeah. The same exact thing. Just photos, and a buddy of mine hand sculpted one and made a mold of it. And so we just started popping them out.
And how much do you sell those for?
What's that?
Yeah. And how much do you sell those for?
We don't sell Disney products here. please see me.
Yeah, good disclaimer there.
And that's so funny. I would say one of the biggest things we get is how do you not get in trouble from Disney?
Mm-hmm. I was going to ask, did Disney notice yet?
Yeah. I know a lot of people that work at Disney, a lot of people, and they all know about it. And everyone's like, everybody I feel like at Disney knows about what I'm, but I think what it is, and obviously I did as much research as possible prior, before we're going to invest all this time and money into this and then 2 weeks later get shut down by Disney. Obviously I've seen hundreds of Disney Airbnbs, Mickey Mouse Airbnbs and this and that, and some of them that have been around for years. And like you said, kind of at the beginning, they're typically all, they're just decorated, Disney decorated. They have Mickey Mouse pictures all over the walls and bedspreads.
If you're lucky, you get a duvet cover.
Right. and what it is, the bottom line is, as long we're not selling anything Disney. We're not, we're not selling Disney merchandise. We're not anything like that. The bottom line is, I own a house. I can decorate my house any way I want. And I'm just inviting people to come look at my house. Like, look what I did to my house. And so there's no, it would be different if we were selling, Disney merchandise and stuff like that illegally, replicating their stuff and reselling it. I know they've cracked down a lot on people that do that, like on Etsy and stuff, that are reselling, Disney inspired art and things like that. So, so right now it's kind of that loophole of like, I'm not selling anything. This is my house. I own this house. I just felt like I'm a big Disney fan. I decorated it all Disney, and I would love people to come see it.
That's kind of
I'm sure Disney will figure it out soon enough.
You're not saying that this is owned by Disney or anything like that, or you're doing anything like that. You call it
Ghostly Retreat.
Pointy's Ghostly Retreat.
Yeah.
Let me try this. You say it better than me.
I try to be very careful about saying, like, this is not Disney's Haunted Mansion.
Right.
I have a few times mentioned that it is Haunted Mansion inspired, but I don't say Disney's Haunted Mansion. I just say Haunted Mansion inspired. So, you know, so we try to, you know, we try our best to keep it on that level. There is nothing I feel like, even all the, like, for example, all the changing portraits and stuff like that. They are, I feel like if you were to just look at it, you would never notice, but they're all, those pictures are not the actual images from the Haunted Mansion. All that artwork, all the artwork in the house is all been completely recreated by an artist, like a hired artist, that of course took the originals and basically made it similar, just kind of put their own spin on it. You know, it's like the woman on the couch, you know, she might in the Disneyland, she might be laying a certain way and she has blonde hair. Well, this one's laying kind of a little differently. She's got black hair. She's wearing different kinds of clothes. But when you see it, you know exactly what it is, but it is not the same image.
Yeah.
So we've kind of, you know, that's kind of how we've done a lot of like the artwork and stuff like that.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. So amazing. So is Haunted Mansion, is that your all-time favorite attraction then at Disneyland?
I mean, I would have to say, I would have to say yes.
Yeah. And you still visit Disneyland all the time?
Yeah. Yeah. I have a pass. I mean, of course, ever since things have changed and stuff, I definitely haven't been happy with the way, you know, how involved it is now. That's really put a damper on things. I've just, you know, I'm just the type of person, and most of the people I know, which is, you know, hard for a lot of us, is, Hey, I just got done working. You want to go to Disneyland right now? Okay, yep, let's go. I mean, that's how it's always been for me my whole life. And to now, you know, oh, well, I can't go. And it's weird sometimes, like, I guess I've kind of learned, like, people say if you link all your passes, but like, I'll say, hey, you know, my buddy Paul, hey, you want to go to Disneyland? It's in like an hour. All right, well, let's try to get a reservation. Well, I was able to get one, but I wasn't.
Yeah.
He was able to get one. I'm like, why? Like, what is...
It's funny you say that, because I'm dealing with that at this moment. I need a reservation. I have four kids, so there's six of us. I need a reservation for all of us for Friday. And I think three of us so far have a reservation. The other three don't. And yeah, you just have to keep going in there and trying to get a reservation. And I mean, so far it's only happened like once where it didn't happen. And maybe only half of us got one. But yeah, that's weird. Like, there's six of us on the... on the app, like, we should be able to just all six grab one. But,
Okay, I'm gonna bring it back to the house. Have you now? There is some. They're not extreme, but there are spooks and scares throughout the house. I think you even say on your website that there's special effects, and if you request to have them turned off, you could text you or whatever, and you could turn them off remotely. Have you had people that were like outright frightened and lose their mind scared in there in the house?
No, I don't think so. I think they're more scared of the unknown. Like, they don't know what's going to happen. Mm-hmm. So I think that scares them. Yeah. To be honest with you, I didn't design this thing to be scary. I mean, I don't feel that the Haunted Mansion is scary. Mm-hmm. You know, it's family friendly, and I kind of wanted that to be like that. I mean, if you, I feel like there's really only one thing that I did purposely to be kind of to scare you is I don't know to give it away, but the effect in the front mirror. And that's really the only thing that I feel like is not really Haunted Mansion related. It's just something I thought would be funny and just to give someone a little scare. And then we have some kind of spooky, just subtle, creepy sounds that happen in the middle of the night. But that's it. I mean, I feel like there's just those two things. And so we have, I think I've had more people, I say more people, I think it's happened twice ever since we've had it booked, two, maybe three times, where people were staying for multiple nights and, you know, they'd hear these like creepy sounds in the middle of the night or something and wake them up. So the next day they're like, can you shut that off? We're trying to sleep. I don't want to hear that. Like, they were more annoyed by it than anything else. And I'm like, I'll shut it off.
We talked about that because we stayed the one night, and then we said, okay, if we stayed multiple nights, we would probably ask it to be shut off, because I'm a chicken, the biggest chicken ever, and I did not sleep after those spooky sounds.
Really?
Yeah. I messaged Holly the next morning. I said, Holly, so did you survive the haunted house? And she replies back, all caps, barely.
It was so funny though, because this house is really big. There's four bedrooms. So we all got our own bedroom, which is really nice. And so, because normally when we rent someplace, we have to share a bedroom. So, I mean, like I said, if these cameras could catch like all the stuff that we did, like, oh my gosh. But yeah, so there's these noises. We won't say again what it is, but I'm laying in bed like, what the heck was that? Am I hearing things? Like, what's going on? And then I hear it again. I hear more. So next thing you see, like, it's straight out of a like sitcom. You see us all running and we're all poking our heads out of our bedroom doors like, what is happening?
And I think, yeah, I guess it's hard for me knowing what's there and what to expect for people that don't know, like, is this going to keep happening? How often? Right. Like, what's next? Well, you know,
yeah.
I feel like it's more of that anticipation that's scary than, you know, what it actually is, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. So funny. So I had a couple people, cause you know, I posted all about it. I had a couple people like, oh my gosh, how could you stay there? Like, oh, that's so scary. And I'm like, scary? Like the same thing, besides the noises, like what you're saying, are you scared of the Haunted Mansion? Like I didn't understand, because like I said, I am a chicken. Like, I really don't do scary movies. Like, I stopped going to like Not Scary Farm years ago. Like, I'm a chicken and I don't know. So it's just really funny when people were just shocked. Like, Holly, I thought I knew you and you're staying at a place. I'm like, what are you talking about? You're so weird.
I will say this. And before we opened and we were rigging up all the effects and deciding, you know, what do we want to do? What is too much? What's not enough? Like, what's that kind of happy medium and stuff like that? So we originally, before it opened and we wound up pulling it, even so, not even one person did the first guest. I don't think they did. I don't think they got to experience it either. But we actually had rumblers mounted under all of the beds. So the beds started shaking violently in the middle of the night. And the problem was just the way we did it. Not only did it shake the bed, they were just the devices that we used were just so, they just made so much noise.
Yeah.
So instead of, we wanted just this, you know, the bed to shake, but you heard this machine more than the bed was shaking. It just went, and this big machine's like shaking the shit out of bed. We're like, we can't do this. Not only is this thing probably going to rattle the bed into pieces, this bed's going to fall apart. But it was scary for sure. Mm-hmm. Like, if that thing went off in the middle of the night with the noise and all that, I'm like, no, we're pulling this.
I think I probably would have thought it was an earthquake before I thought it was a ghost.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah.
Being in California, I could.
But, oh my gosh. Well, I have to say, I'm glad that effect was not there. That's so funny. Oh, I love it. Oh,
not to say that we probably won't add different things in the future, so we'll see.
Yeah.
That is great. Well, I hope to be able to stay there one day, that's for sure.
But like I said, I mean, the idea overall is, you know, I've had people ask and I said, if you're scared of the Haunted Mansion, then you'll probably be scared. If you're not scared of the Haunted Mansion ride,
right,
you're not really good.
Yeah.
You know, it's not designed to be scary. You know?
Yeah.
But I will say, I've had multiple people, I'm telling the truth, and this isn't me, but I've had multiple, like at least a half a dozen, if not more people, ask me about effects in the house that don't exist.
Oh.
Like, they've asked about how I got a projection of a person to, where is the projector that's projecting the shadow of the person going across the dining room? And I'm like, there's no projection.
You're like, I can't tell you my secret.
Right. You know, it, like, they will say, like, there, we saw this and there's that. And like, there was some crazy, I'm like, I don't know what you're talking about because that's not my stuff.
Oh, great. So the place actually is haunted.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, great. Yeah.
Yeah, so that's what we wanted to hear.
Special effects. Right? That was the real noises.
We gotta start wrapping this up here.
Yeah.
I wanted to say, so it's a 4-bedroom, 2-bathroom. You have a, what is it, a hot tub in the backyard?
Yep. Yeah. I have a hot tub in the back. We have a little mini putting green back there. We've got, the bag toss cornhole game out there,
which is also coolie themed as well.
Oh yeah. 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 The
boards There's are a cool. barbecue. Like I said, it's so clean too. Like it's just beautiful.
And then there's a game room, which is the stretching room we talked about.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it has a table in the middle of the room. That's, if you wanted to, you could flip over the lid, and there's a bumper pool table and a poker table, and the room is filled with tons of board games and stuff like that, decks of cards and all kinds of things like that.
Yeah. And Holly, you guys did some, you brought like themed treats when you went.
Yeah. Yeah. Of course we had to do that. So that was fun. But we were a little confused on what we should do because there was Hocus Pocus premiering that day, and then Nightmare Before Christmas, and then Haunted Mansion. So we had a variety, but yeah, that was a lot of fun too. We all.
Does it have Disney Plus? Treats. Could you watch Disney Plus there?
Oh, yes. Yep. We watched Hocus Pocus too while we were there. Yeah. So I was like, there's no way there isn't going to be Disney Plus. So.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. It's kind of a mandatory thing to have.
I don't even know if there's a TV because you never even talked about the TV at all. How do you know there was a TV? In there?
Yeah. There's TVs in all the bedrooms and there's a big TV in the living room.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And even the TV in the living room is framed in with like an authentic, like timed frame, so you can't even really tell that it's a TV because even that is framed in beautifully. So
and of course it's all, you get the Haunted Mansion wallpaper in all the different rooms and all the different theming and everything. So it's you did an amazing job with it from the pictures and the videos I've seen. Absolutely amazing. And if people want to book this, they go to Airbnb Ghostly Retreat, or
I think the way that
we'll post it in the show notes, but it's airbnb.com/H. I don't know why H, but /ghostly retreat. So, but we'll add it in the show notes if anybody wants to book it. Totally affordable, worth it. You should absolutely stay there. And every one of us want to stay there again without the overlay just to see what it looks like. Because, I mean, we saw with the overlay and I love the overlay. Now we got to see what you did for regular Haunted Mansion. So thank you so much, Jeff.
Yeah, no, thank you guys. It's been an honor.
Yeah, this was great. People, you got to check out Holly's. I guess it's on yours or is on Grand Circle Tours Instagram mostly?
It's both. Well, there were 6 of us, so Jeff has been bombarded with posts and reels, and we just had way too much fun there. It's all over. But if you go to my Instagram, Crawford's on the go, you can see them, and it was a lot of fun.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much, Jeff. It's been a blast. And Ken, take it away.
The Grand Circle Tour podcast is brought to you by Expedition Roasters. When you visit expeditionroasters.com, use the promo code Grand Circle Tour Podcast. That's all one word, and you'll receive 10% off of your order. If you would like to keep the adventure going after the show, be sure to like our Facebook friends page, Grand Circle Tour Magical Ticket Holders. While you're on Facebook, like our group page, Grand Circle Tours. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, Grand Circle Tour Podcast, as well as Instagram GCT Podcast, and our YouTube channel, Grand Circle Tour, and on TikTok at Grand Circle Tour Podcast. That's all one word. If you would like to email us, drop us a line at gctpodcast@gmail.com. T-shirts and other fun merchandise can be found at tpublic.com. Simply search Grand Circle Tour Podcast. If you enjoyed your adventure, leave us a review on Apple Podcast. Only one rule, make it good. All logos, sounds, songs, and music that are made by and for Disney and its affiliates are owned in full by the Disney Corporation and are not, nor are they intended to be owned in any way by the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. Thank you for riding with us, and welcome home.
Please exit to your left by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.
Please exit by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.